is a place where great leaders find themselves. After two sessions of interesting conversations with four unique personalities, we are here with two more great individuals who have led the Rotary Club of the University of Chittagong throughout the years. Let me introduce the third president of the club for the years 2013 and 2014, Rotary Vice President Sarod Sovaratna, and the seventh president of the club for the years 2017 and 2018, Rotary Vice President Samudya Amarasinghe. Good evening, Ayas, and welcome. So, you might be curious as to what we have prepared for you today. Let me brief you on the session plan. There will be two phases, but the first phase will be five questions each for the both of you regarding your Rotary journey, and then there will come an exciting session where there will be 10 questions each for the both of you. This will be a rapid fire session and we will only need short answers for this session. Starting off with Samudaya, I will ask you, tell us about your Rotary journey, how you started Rotary, first project and etc.
Now back in those days, when we came to university, like it was surprising for me the culture and everything. But it surprisingly, I came up a post with regards to Rotary one day. So I can still remember Rotary Club president Osadar came into our lecture hall and asked for people to join the Rotary. So we were curious about what is this. Okay. Like then we went to the first meeting, and if I am not mistaken, the first project was Sihina. So first meeting we had at race course. So there I shared the project, and that's how we got into the road track. And like it's an amazing journey. If we see the journey throughout the time, like we got many friends all around the country with many cultures, many backgrounds, and everything like. It's a total different journey. Like, I have no words at this moment to explain the total picture of it.
You have a good memory of your start of the project. Aya, Sarojaya, I'll ask you the same question. How was your road track journey?
I started my CMA at Achievers, and I saw some students doing some extracurricular activities back then, then I was thinking, okay, when I go back to the uni, probably I'll start doing some extracurricular activities, because till then I wasn't doing anything at school even. I was a silent bugger at the school. So then I came to the uni, and I saw Devin, who was my previous president, and Asri was doing some interesting projects. If I go back in my memory lane, they did some visits to orphanages and all those things. So I felt it's a good place to be, because I didn't have a clique back then. So then I joined Rotary. So that was it.
So Samudaya, you definitely must have had an amazing group of individuals behind you. Tell us about the support and the backup that you had during your year.
Initially by boat, like surprisingly we had around 20 heads in our boat for the first time in Rotary history. That was a surprise for the entire Rotary 3220 district, surprise, because starting from Divya, secretary, then PUNI treasurer, and the rest of the board. So among those, all the past residents, starting from Asri Aya, all were talking to me through message and everything. Asri Aya that time was in USA, if I'm not mistaken. So like, it's great. And then the junior team, like when we started, the crowd is around 5 or 10. The total club is around. Then we engage on PR, taking everyone into the road track, having all the fights and everywhere. We are having many issues, but then the Oshani came into the play, and like Oshani is the main player there. So she took the junior level, and like I can't pinpoint these are the people who support us. These are not the people, like the entire club. At the end of my year, the crowd is around 600 members. So this is the cluster who helped me throughout the year.
Sarojaya, our club was recognized as one of the largest clubs in the district, if I'm not mistaken, with over 250 members. This must have been huge. And how was this experience and the support that you got from your club?
Actually, if I'm not mistaken, what we did at the beginning itself was we divided the club into 3 or 4 parts with that member base. But when Samudaya told, I felt a bit proud and happy as well, because the membership has grown over the years. Somehow he has taken it to 600 members, so that's like almost the double. But back at our time, what I have to say is that 250 managing it by one person wasn't possible at all. So we divided into three parts, and people did projects separately, and there were leaders at those groups as well, and the board, as I want to mention, and the previous president, because they were supporting, and we had huge issues with the deans and with the other deans, and sometimes they wanted to sack me, they wanted me to come and publicly apologize for certain things. So there were issues like that, but there were set of people, especially Sampath Amaratunga, who's now the UGC chairman, and they stood behind me and telling, okay, you can do this and all these things. And there were some people, I can't mention everyone's name, but people sacrificed a lot for my it was not actually my alone, like my sole effort, but that's how it ended up.
Okay, so Samudaya, Butterfly Effect, the project that you did on mental health, was awarded the Gold Award for the most outstanding special project during your year. What were the experiences that you had in this project along with the other club projects?
Number one, before we were recognized as the Gold Award for the Mental Community Awards, we were recognized as the best friend in Sri Lanka within 1 week of launching the project by TNL. So like, we were the number one friend. That was done by a state university with so many cultures, and like before my year, like we were like doing around 0 to 5 for the 100%, and we were having on, as I mentioned earlier, we were having about 10 to 15 members only. After Sarvajaya, it decreased and we came to around 10 to 15 members. So like, we were not performing. So with this effort, taking from 15 to 600 members, and the very next month we were the number one trend in Sri Lanka. So for that,
even I can remember that project.
Yeah, for that I would first recognize Tanushi Akka and Tanuri, who were the pioneers in starting the campaign. Like we were thinking about what to do out of box to take members in. Like everyone go give this, this donate this, this thing to this charity and doing all those charity things. But is there any out of box thing we can do? So like, they came into the play, and like, we were having discussion all around for maybe 1.5 weeks throughout nights, and having like at the last moment, if I'm not mistaken, we were to give up. Like, but Tanushaka came into the play and came with this idea, Butterfly Effect. So we will launch it, and initially we were recognized as the best, the number one trending PR campaign in Sri Lanka. Then we were recognized by the Rock Tractor newspaper, USA. This is the first time the state university got recognized in the Rock Tractor USA newspaper. That's the international Rock Track newspaper. And thereafter, at the end of the year, as you mentioned, we won the award. So there were about two phases. Number one, we were just launched the PR campaign. The number two is the operational launch, which were headed by the Chaturni and the team. So there we got the chance to cooperate with the Sumitreo Foundation. So like, it's a massive campaign. Like, we were able to talk to many people who underwent all those experiences with suicidal effect and everything. So like, it's amazing.
That's a great achievement, I see. So talking about achievements, Sarojaya, the Rotaract Club of the city of Shijawa, Dinapura, won over 5 awards in the Rotaract District Assembly for the first time, and the project Netu Dhasa, if you remember, received the Silver Award for the most outstanding community service initiative. How was this experience for you and the memories that you gathered in these club projects?
Okay, so one thing that I want us to remember is not the awards that we got, because awards were good at that time. To be honest, even I was motivated by awards, but when I'm thinking now, I don't remember actually when you just said it's the Silver Award, only I remembered it was a Silver Award. But now what I remember are the memories that we cherished back then. So the biggest award that we have received up to now is, I think, the impact that we created. For example, from Netudahasa, the impact that we created to the Blind Society, we collected around 1 million rupees from that concert. So that was the highest donation in that time period as well. So I would say, in my point of view, people worked hard, all the members in the club, to benefit someone else. So that was the biggest award that we got back then. Other than that, yeah, there were some awards which I can't remember, to be honest. But we created some impact, which I believe is a reward and an objective and an achievement as well.
That's true, that's true. So coming back to Samudaya, Rotaract Fellowship Summit was organized in line with the district theme of the year, Engage Rotaract, Redefine Friendship, and to commemorate the Golden Jubilee of the Rotaract movement. How was the support that you got from Rotaractors of our club along with the clubs of your district?
Now, this project also something like we wanted to end up the year like in a separate manner. So like everyone was in a mind to finish off all the projects, to go for the citations and everything, but we were in a mind to finish off the year with something different. So like we were thinking only the district is organizing all those pets and sets and everything, but why can't we organize the thing? So we took the step and at that time we had an issue because the state university had a strike and we were about to face the final examination. So it's an uncertain period for us, but we took the risk and everything. And the other thing is the budget issues, right? It was around, if I'm not mistaken, around 1 million to 1.1 million budget. So like donations we can't use, we have to have fundraisers and everything. So the very first thing is our finance team. So the finance team got the burden and everything, and like within 1 month they covered about half the budget, and then the rest of the organizing team, because this RFS is it's a 3-day project where we took everyone into the MA's Tulhiriya. And we organize everything like not only our people, we are getting people from other clubs as well. So we have to have a proper agenda without making dull for everyone. So like at one point I can remember we were not in a position to have separate professional people to come and conduct workshops and everything. So we came into the play and we organized everything. We did all the PT sessions, we did all the motivational sessions and everything. It's a separate thing. So we thought around about 20 to 50 people will join the RS Summit, but at the end of the day, 200 people participated for the event. So that's how it went.
So Sarojaya, you were the first member of our club to be selected to serve in the Rotaract District Committee. This must have been a huge experience for you, I'm sure. How was that experience?
I was the community service director back then because I was selected because of my sole interest on community service. All the projects that we did was majority focused on that, because people were like willing to do charity. That's what I understood. So as I told you, my club was divided into three parts from the beginning itself, and they were given the driving hand most of the time. I was just a facilitator, I would say. So how I got that was because most of our projects were focused on community service. Then when I was in the district, mainly we did the Down Syndrome Day. I don't know whether Down Syndrome Day continues up to now. I don't think, no, it's not happening now. With Kosaladulla Foundation, it's not happening, no? So I think after I did my year with Pavani, if I'm not mistaken, after that year, Asela did that. Asela is my VP at our university. So after Asela, the Down Syndrome Day stopped. So that was a good achievement or a milestone, I would say, because all those kids who have Down Syndrome participated on that day, and they came to a Royal College and they spent a full day there. They get those talent shows where they dance and they participated, and at the end of the day their families are happy and they get a free health clinic and all those things. So that was the impact that I could create. And also we helped people with sponsorships and all those as well for people, for other clubs, me being in the community service director in the district. So those are the things that I can remember of now, because obviously it's after 6 years I'm talking about those things. To be honest, I can't clearly remember what I did as well. But it's always good to go back there and cherish those memories.
6 years of memories is huge.
Yes.
This question is the last question of this phase, and this goes to the both of you. I'll ask this from you, Samudaya. What would you say is your biggest learning from your year as a president?
Biggest learning? That's something very hard to answer, but one thing, it's not about learning, like, it's about building my skills on like managing about 600 people, looking into each and everyone's needs and everything. And in the meantime, developing of patience with external issues and everything. So like, it's about managing an organization in Sri Lanka. Like the whole concept is.
I'm sorry. The same question goes to you, Sarojaya.
Yeah, the biggest learning, right?
Yes.
If I put it into a few words, I would say be humble, be open, and recognize others. So the same thing, I think, as Samudaya said, in different words.
So now comes the exciting part of the session. It's a rapid-fire question session. We require just short answers for this. I'd rather if you just answer me the first thing that comes to your mind. And I'll start off with some of the efforts and then come over to you. Okay. So I hope you're ready.
Okay.
What is the most unforgettable memory that you have with the Rotary Club of University of Sri Java?
RFS.
Name three things you learned from Rotary?
Name three things. First thing, as Sarojaya told, being open, being humble. The rest is like managing the whole crowd.
Who is the Rotaract role model and why?
Rotaract role model. Like, to be honest, I didn't have anyone. To be honest, right? Because I. This was my first experience. Like, I joined Rotaract about 1 month or 2 months back, and after 2 months I got elected as the president. So that's it.
So name three projects which were so close to your heart during your year.
First one is the movie marathon. Second one, Butterfly Effects. Third one, RFS. Yes.
Were you a person who would attend an installation just to eat food?
I was the person to attend installation. Yeah, 50% yes, 50% no. That's
some yes, no.
Yeah.
Okay. Give one piece of advice for our current president of the club.
Arrange more project like this with maybe with dinner or lunch.
Okay, I hope I'm not hears this. Ever been scolded by your parents for going out open and coming home late just because of Rotaract?
No, not at all.
Never?
Yeah.
How even? Even I get scolded now. Name one thing you've always wanted to change in our club.
At that time, the culture. Because I was in a mind that there was a mind in the university that Rotaract is only for the club of people and only for the upper class people.
Even now it's there.
But at that our time, we changed at least for 50%.
Even still, there's that depth thought from you. Even my friends teach me. So the next question is, name five friends that you made from Rotaract.
Just only from Rotaract?
Yes.
But from the university? Pidushit, there. I met him at the RFS. If I take my board, the whole 18 people were there. So like, not only the three people. So with these 18 people, I should tell Oshani, then Vidushit, then Chatuni, then. So all those one, I can't pinpoint all these ones.
And the final question is, final question for you. What does Rotaract Club of the University of Sri Jayawardenepura mean to you?
Means to be, it's a family.
I would say Netudahasa.
What was the biggest challenge you had during COVID?
Managing conflicts.
Name five friends you made for
Rotaract. As Samudra said, there were a lot, but closest up to till now, Devin, Shanaka, then Shashika, Inuri, Nikuni, and there's a lot. So I can keep on going. That's if I keep it short, right after my installation, half of my board wanted to leave. So that is an unforgettable memory after my installation. Be humble, that is, I said before, but and be open, and then again I would say be humble. So that solves problems.
Who is your Rotaract role model and why?
It was Devin, I would say Devin, because he was really passionate about what he did. He did a lot of PD events which I didn't like, but other than that, it was all good.
I hope you have you ever looked at a fellow Rotaractor as someone who was more than just a friend?
Yes. Asela, he is in Australia now.
Describe your board of directors in one word.
Do I want to tell the truth or I want to be nice? Okay. They were awesome, and I was the asshole. So.
And advice to our fellow club members?
Make sure when you go to Rotaract to see, not to think about what you are getting, but think about what you can give. Because if you give something proper to the club, definitely you get something in return.
And finally, what does Rotaract Club of University of Sri Jayawardenepura mean to you?
Listening to Samudaya as well, it used to be very secluded, but then after that it became like anyone could join, so it became a family, but more than that, anyone were welcome there, so anyone, it was open to everyone.
So with that, we are reaching the end of the session. Sarojaya and Samudaya, thank you for joining with us today. I know that you are busy with your studies, but yet you accepted our invitation without hesitation. Thank you very much. Await another exciting and fun session, and make sure that you don't miss it.